Friday was Earth Day, a reminder that amid all the acute crises in the world today, the long-term climate crisis rages on. Earth's leaders made some progress at last year's COP26 climate conference, but the finger was pointed at India and China for watering down the final agreement. It highlights the frustration felt by many climate activists. No matter how much they reduce carbon emissions in their own countries, India and China remain addicted to coal. Well, the Rockefeller Foundation leads a group of organizations that have a big idea. They aim to raise $100 billion in public and private funds to bring renewable power to some 1 billion people and avoid sending 4 billion tons of greenhouse gas emissions into the atmosphere. I spoke to Raj Shah about this. He is the president of the Rockefeller Foundation and the former head of the U.S. Agency for International Development. Welcome, Raj.
Thanks, Fareed.
So first, let me put this in perspective. It would be fair to say, I mean, the Rockefeller Foundation is famous for igniting the green revolution around the world, which created agricultural productivity that allowed countries like India to feed itself, in fact, become a food exporter. Is this on the scale of that kind of effort?
This is absolutely on that scale. And this is perhaps a bigger challenge. You know, today, in order for us to defeat climate change, we have to approach this problem in a way that includes everybody. And nearly 3 billion people on this planet only consume less than 1,000 kilowatt hours per year of energy and electricity. That's 1/12 of what a typical American would consume. So they're going to consume more energy over time. And the question is it going to be more coal, or is it going to be renewable electrification and new energy technologies that can protect our planet and help those important families and communities lift themselves up? And we're advocating for the latter.
So tell us, what is, you know, with the Green Revolution, there was all this new technology that was used. What is the technology at the core of your bet? What is it that makes you think you can provide that much energy, that much power, that much electricity to those many people?
Well, the answer to that question is really renewable energy systems. We've seen over the last decade, as Rockefeller's been pioneering this work to reach lower income communities with, say, solar mini grids, we've seen the cost of power go down significantly. Photovoltaics have gone down 90%. Energy storage is down more than 80%. We're about to make a huge leap into lithium ion phosphate battery storage for stationary grids and small mini and micro grids. It's now cheaper to provide power this way than it is to provide it through either dirty diesel generators or coal connected to grids that try to reach into these communities and do so poorly. So I've walked through these communities and seen.
Why is the market not doing it already? Why do we need the Rockefeller Foundation?
Well, most government utilities look at providing power to rural communities in particular as just a traditional loss maker. You know, to them, it's you build a big coal plant near a city, connected to a grid. The extra cost of connecting grid connections out to rural communities, to villages, to small towns and cities in those settings is expensive. And then the power that they deliver on it is erratic, and their systems are not very good for doing that. These new systems are loaded with technology. In addition to photovoltaics and battery storage, they also use remote artificial intelligence-based energy management systems. We have smart meters that allow a very poor household to pay for only what they consume and do so via their phone and do it very efficiently so that these systems are economically productive. And frankly, because these work, we've partnered with Tata Power, which is now rolling out 10,000 of these systems in India. We'll get the cost down to under 15 cents a kilowatt hour, at which point it beats every alternative source of energy, and we'll help 25 million people not just move out of poverty, but do it on a green development path that's safe for our planet and for their local communities.
When will we see real results on this kind of scale you're describing? Because as you said, so far what you've done is impressive, but small scale. When will we see millions and millions and millions of people on these grids?
Well, you're absolutely right. First, I'd say we've already reached about 1 million customers, 550,000 in India alone. And what we see from those customers is not just that they pay their bills and they use power and electricity. We see that they move themselves up the economic ladder. They might buy an electric sewing machine and start a small business, or they might be an agricultural producer who then uses a rice hulling machine to, you know, improve their economics of their own business and lift their families up. That trend is taking off all over the world, and we believe that we will hit the targets we defined at the COP of reaching 1 billion people within a decade with renewable energy, so that they're no longer underserved and they're finally connected to the economic ladder of globalization, and they can lift up themselves and their communities out of poverty.
Raj Shah, this is a terrific, ambitious project, and we wish you well.